Modern SecOps needs automation to work efficiently, and this video describes how you can use Power Automate to do just that. In this example, our SecOps sees a lot of infrequent country alerts, and a good number of them are legitimate activities. To save time, I'll use Power Automate to triage these alerts so we can focus on the actual threats. My criteria for resolving these alerts is that the user has an out-of-office message turned on and is not at high risk. If both are true, I'll assume it's legitimate travel and mark the alert as resolved. In either case, we'll post notifications in Microsoft Teams. We'll connect Power Automate to Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps to create our automation, so we'll need an API token. To do that, on the Settings page, select Cloud Apps, followed by API Tokens. Then, select Add Token, type a descriptive name so you remember it later, and select Generate. Save the token, because you'll never see it again. Here in Power Automate, I'll do the cooking show thing to get the flow started, and then pull a completed flow out of the oven to give you a proper tour. To get started, select Create, and then Automated Cloud Flow. This uses a trigger, like an alert, to get things started. Then, name your flow, and select when an alert is generated by using the Defender for Cloud Apps connector. When done, select Create to begin editing your flow. The first thing you see is the trigger that will get everything started. To finish connecting it to Defender for Cloud Apps, paste the API token you created earlier into API key, and then select Create. Now, we just need some actions. The first will be to get the user's profile from Microsoft 365. So, select New Step, search for User Profile, and then select Get User Profile. This step requires the UPN, or email address of a user, and the Defender for Cloud Apps connector just happens to provide that. Select the user box, search the keyword entity, and then select Compromised Entity to add it. Now, the user's profile information will be available in the remaining steps of our flow. It's really that simple to build automations in Power Automate. I encourage you to see the documentation to learn more about it. In the meantime, I'll pull the rest of the flow out of the oven to explain it. That's next. The entire flow, beginning to end, has 7 steps. The first step is the trigger that kicks everything off, and the second step gets the user's profile information from Microsoft 365. After that, the Get Manager action works like the previous step. It just requires the UPN or email address, and it returns information about that person's manager. I'll use that information when posting notifications in Microsoft Teams. The next two steps simply get the out-of-office message from the user's mailbox, and looks up the user in Microsoft Entra ID Protection to get the account's risk level. An out-of-office message and a risk level other than high are my conditions for resolving infrequent travel alerts automatically. And now we're getting to the fun part, composing the content and layout of our Teams message. We post it later in the flow. It uses values from the Defender for Cloud Apps, Microsoft 365, Microsoft Entra ID Protection, and Outlook connectors to create a meaningful and detailed message. Which leads me to the choice our flow must make. If the user has an out-of-office message turned on and the risk level is not high, the flow will perform the if-yes steps on the left. Otherwise, it'll perform the if-no steps. In the first case, the flow automatically resolves the threat as benign and adds a comment to it. Following that, it posts a message to the alerts channel in the SOC team that says the alert was automatically resolved, followed by the details we composed earlier. If either condition is not true, the if-no step on the other side simply posts the alert to the same channel without resolving it. The last step is to connect the appropriate Defender for Cloud Apps alert policy to the flow. The activity from infrequent country policy is built in, and we've connected it to our flow by choosing to send alerts to Power Automate and selecting the flow we created earlier. Of course, seeing is believing. The activity from infrequent country alert in this incident triggered our flow, which automatically resolved the alert and posted a message in the SOC team. Using Power Automate with Microsoft 365 Defender can help reduce time doing repetitive work, so you can spend more time hunting and investigating real threats. To learn more, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.